Good evening, folks. My name is Bob Mudd, and I am the president of Adventures in Mission. We are in unprecedented times. We've never, in the history of our ministry, been more excited about what we see the Lord doing all around the world. And at the same time, the events of the recent months obviously has set the world into a state of fear. Since the news was released about the outbreak of the coronavirus in China, we have focused very intently on the safety of both those that we mobilize as well as the people that we serve and we try to reach for Christ. We have tried to stay on mission to share the gospel, to be an expression of His kingdom, to fulfill the Great Commission as we've been commanded to do, while at the same time looking at the information provided by the CDC, state departments, the World Health Organization, by the information that we could assimilate from on the ground, and feedback coming from each of the independent countries in which we try to reach. In doing so, we have made adjustments all along the way. In recent days, the developments have been fast-moving. We have seen a continued expansion of the footprint of the virus. Information coming out of the countries in which we serve have become inconsistent and at times delayed in its nature. Additionally, countries have been changing policies very quickly in terms of who can be allowed in and the nature in which people can travel to and from within the country. Travel resources, both domestically and internationally, are being stressed as a function of these fast-moving changes. In addition to the information and actions that have been taken by the countries in which we serve, the U.S. has also been taking quick and aggressive action as it relates to its own borders. We have been assessing this information over time, and the options for the folks that are on the field have become more narrow and narrow over time as well. It's after much prayer and consideration and review of our options that we've had to make the very difficult decision to bring World Race Gap Year, and semesters back to the United States. Over the coming days, we have an all-hands-on-deck approach to facilitate the movement of hundreds of people safely and effectively back into the United States. In the coming days, we will be effective at communicating directly with participants and their loved ones as we make arrangements for their return to the United States. Upon return to the United States, our team is going to be working to help the returning missionaries debrief well. There's a lot of questions that are left unanswered. There's information that we don't know. We don't know the trajectory of this virus in the United States, and we certainly don't know it in a lot of the developing countries in which we work. We will be focusing on answering these questions in the days and the weeks ahead related to, do I get to go back out? What are the financial implications and so forth? But we are currently focused on safe and efficient return of our missionaries back to the United States. We remain very passionate about our mission and look forward to getting those called to the Great Commission and the Great Commandment back on the field soon. We have a lot of people that are waiting and wondering what this summer looks like as they are planning to go out, and we fully expect to be able to facilitate the continued expansion of Jesus and His kingdom all around the world. In the meantime, we covered your prayer, and we appreciate your partnership. Have a good evening.